How Christianity came to Ireland. Initially, Christianity spread throughout the Roman Empire. As we can see from the map, Ireland was slightly outside this area. The Christian message would come to Ireland through four different routes. The most important, due to their geographical proximity, were those from Britain and those from France. However, there are also historical accounts of a sea route from northern Spain to southern Ireland, so this also should not be discounted. Finally, although of course far less common, is the route from North Africa through the Strait of Gibraltar and directly to Ireland. Considering these routes in relation to a map of Ireland, it should be obvious why in early Irish Christian history we find more Christians at first in Munster and Leinster, because the missionaries via these different routes are going to arrive in the south of Ireland rather than the north. And Christianity, of course, would come to Connacht and Ulster, but that would be slightly later. The first important figure to arrive near Ireland and therefore have an effect, whether directly or indirectly, on Ireland was Saint Aristobulus, who was one of the 70 disciples mentioned in Luke 10. Aristobulus is actually mentioned by name in Romans 16:10, and according to Orthodox tradition, he went to Britain to preach, and so is known as the first bishop of Britain. He travelled to Britain via the route from northern Spain. Another important figure to mention is Saint Irenaeus of Lyon. Because of what he represents in the sense of the movement of these great teachers from the east to the west, he was from Smyrna, which would be modern day Turkey, but moved to France by the request of the Christian community there for a great teacher to be their bishop. And he is especially famous for writing against heresies. That was in the 2nd century, and by the 4th century, we would find great saints born in Western Europe, for example, Saint Hilary of Poitiers and his student, Saint Martin of Tours, who would become especially important for Irish monasticism. Here we can see a photo of his most important monastery, Marmoutier Abbey. This was an especially important monastery for Ireland because it acted as a training ground for missionaries who would go to Britain and Ireland, and also would be a place that many Irish saints would actually come to this monastery, be inspired by its example, and then return to Ireland to establish monasteries along similar lines and share the wisdom that they learned there. It's for this reason also that St. Martin was especially venerated by Irish Christians. Another important saint to mention is St. Germanus of Auxerre, who travelled to Britain to fight against the heresy known as Pelagianism, which brought him very physically close to Ireland. But also, he's especially worth mentioning in relation to Ireland because he would be one of the teachers of St. Patrick. We've now reached a point at which we would be talking about saints who are primarily known for their relationship to Ireland, although they weren't born in Ireland, such as St. Patrick and St. Palladius, as well as those who actually were born in Ireland, sometimes known as the pre-patrician saints. So that's what I would like to discuss next time. Also, if you'd like to read more about what I've talked about in this video, as well as much more content, you can visit my blog, which will also be linked in the description. Thank you.